This video is on the topic of the Reflex app. Let's start by defining a reflex response. A reflex response differs from a voluntary response because it does not have to involve the brain as the coordinator. Reflex actions are involuntary or automatic, meaning they happen without you consciously deciding to carry out the response. They are also very rapid. The most common purpose of a reflex is to protect the body from potential damage, such as touching a hot surface. The term reflex arc refers to the sequence of neurons that the impulse passes along in order to trigger the reflex response. This is always the same sequence and is shown here in the diagram. The stimulus is the trigger of the reflex, such as touch, light, or sound. The three types of neurons transmit the impulse in one direction, which results in the effector, such as a muscle or a gland, carrying out the response. Let's take an example of stepping on a sharp pin. The pressure from the pin is the stimulus and is detected by the receptors on the sole of the foot. This triggers the electrical nerve impulse to start and to travel up the leg along the sensory neurone. The sensory neurone sends the impulse to the spinal cord, which acts as the coordinator. The impulse passes across the synapse to a relay neuron in the central nervous system. The spinal cord sends the impulse to the motor neuron via another synapse, although another impulse is simultaneously sent to the brain to ensure there is a conscious awareness of the stimulus. The motor neuron is the final neuron in the arc and sends the impulse to the effector, which in this case is the muscle of the leg, which contracts and brings about the response of moving the foot away from the pin. It is important to remember that there are sometimes differences in how reflex arcs function for different examples. For example, some reflexes are not coordinated by the spinal cord, such as the example shown here, which involves the eyes. Also, some reflex arcs don't have relay neurons, so the impulse is able to very quickly be transmitted straight from the sensory neuron to the motor neuron. In an exam, you may be presented with application questions with different examples, some of which you may have never come across before. Make sure you know how to apply your knowledge in these instances. A question you could get asked about the reflex arc is to calculate the speed of a nerve impulse. An example is shown here. In order to work out the time taken for the impulse to occur, we need to use the equation speed equals distance divided by time. For time, we rearrange this equation to make time equals distance divided by speed. Once we've done that, we can set in the numbers from the question into the equation to make 1.7 divided by 110, which gives us an end answer of 0.015 seconds. Always make sure to include units in your answers to maths questions. In summary, a reflex response is an automatic, rapid, and protective response to a stimulus, which does not need to involve the brain as a coordinator. The reflex arc follows a sequence of stimulus, receptor, sensory neuron, relay neuron, motor neuron, effector, followed by a response. The gap between two neurons is called a synapse, and signals are transmitted across the synapse following the diffusion of chemicals called neurotransmitters. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.